Good morning, Stuart. Thank you for this story. Today, in this session, I'm going to take our list and into array list and its method in Java. So, before getting to the story, let us have a things on array. Okay. So,
ma'am, what are you recommending, ma'am?
No, ma'am, not clear, ma'am. Break card, ma'am.
It is audible.
No, ma'am.
காயத்ரி லாக் அவுட் பண்ணிட்டோம்னா திருப்பி வெளியில வாங்க திருப்பி உள்ள வாங்க
Is it audible to you? Ashok sir?
காயத்ரி மா பிரேக் ஆகுது.
பிரேக் ஆகுதா?
ஆமா. இல்ல காயத்ரிமா பிரேக் ஆயிட்டு தான் இருக்கு.
ஓகேவா ஷாமிலி மேம்? ஓகேவா?
ஓகேமா ஓகேமா பேசுங்க.
சரி மூவ் பண்றேன் இப்போ. ஓகேவா? சரி ஓகே
ஓகே.
திஸ் இஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட். ஓகே ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் குவிஸ். ஆக்சுவலி ஐ ஹவ் சேஞ்ச் டு மை தேர்ட் மைக். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் குவிஸ். Just post it in your answer in the chat box. Very easy one, right? So what is the length of the following array? So your topic is related to array list. That is why I'm choosing array here. What is the length of the following? So here, name of the array, which is data. What's the type of your array, which is byte? Yes. The length of the array means how many elements in your array, right? So almost 6 elements. Yes. Sorry. நெக்ஸ்ட் So here, using the for loop, I'm just iterating over an array using the for loop. So here, your name of the array, which is example array, type, which is integer. So I have already initialized some values. So that these values are iterating using the for loop. Okay, so your for loop starting with zero. Okay, so your for loop starting with zero, index is zero and index less. Less only 5. Okay, so less than 5. So your array is also, what's the starting index of your array? So your array is starting with 0, 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so array of 0 means 2 will be displayed. Example array of 1 means 4. Example array of 2 means 6. Example of array of 3 means 8. Okay, example of array of 4 means 10. If it is 5 means, okay, just move or get out of from the for loop. Okay, so only 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, up to 10, okay, 2, 4, so since your array is starting with 0, 0, 0 in the place 2, so 1 in the place 4, 2 in the place 6, 3 in the place 8, 4 in the place 10, okay, so your for loop only index less than 5 only, less than or equal to 5, only less than 5, so up to 4 only it is executed. While coming to the 5, just move out of from the for loop. Okay. So your answer 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 is only displayed. Okay. Next. Here. What is the output of the following code fragment? So the same thing. Array is initialized with some values. Your name of array, example array, the type integer. So using the for loop, you're just iterating over an array. Okay, so your for loop starting with index 0, less than example array dot length. Your length is there. So how do you calculate the length of the array? A predefined method, length. Okay, using the length function. Okay, we are going to calculate your array length. Okay, so your for loop. So see here, what's the third one? Index. Here, index is not usually are using index equal to index plus plus, right? Index plus plus means index equal to index plus 1. But here, index equal to index plus 2. Keep it in mind. Okay, index plus 2. What is the result? So an index starting with 0, so up to move on to length, but the iteration, how it make over the iteration? Okay. Index plus 2. Okay. What about others? Some few one are answer. Okay. Then actually, yes, C. Okay, so C means index 0. So 0 plus 2, 2, 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 2, 6. Okay, 6 plus 2, so 8. So here only 0 to 9 combinations are there. Okay, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So up to 9. So the position on 0, the position on 2, the position on 4, the position on 6, the position on 8. Okay, so display 2, 6, 10, then 3, 7. Okay. Okay, let us move on to the actual topic, array list. Array list. A few words related to array. Okay. A few words on array. Your standard Java arrays. Your standard Java arrays are a fixed length. Okay, so arrays are a fixed length. Arrays is the concept comes into the reference data type. We have already seen in the first unit, which belongs to the reference data type. So your arrays are fixed length. After arrays are created, they cannot be grow or shrink, which means we cannot resize arrays. This is a very important point with respect to array. After arrays are created, they cannot grow or shrink, which means we cannot resize the arrays. Okay. The third point on array. Arrays are useful. Okay. What time? When we know in advance how many elements the array is to be hold. Okay. In this situation only, arrays are very useful and flexible. Okay, so arrays are useful when we know in advance how many elements the array is hold. Okay, these are some few important points pertaining to array. Okay, so array is the main thing. Arrays are fixed length; it cannot resized. Okay, it cannot growable. Okay, so situations means we have to know the size of the array in advance. Okay. Next, array list. Actually, array list in Java. Coming to the concept of collection. Okay, that is the definition starting with here. Array list, the fourth one point, array list is a collection. Okay, so array, which is belongs to the reference data type. But here, array list is a separate one, a collection. One of the important concept in Java, which will be very helpful for in hacker and problem. Okay, while you are solving hacker problems without connection, sometimes it is very difficult to track the problem. Okay, find out the solution of the problem. So in your syllabus, they have given only one collection topic, which is array list. Okay, so many topics are there. Not only array list, linked list, then queues, then set, hash set, linked hash set. Map, hash map, so many things are available in collection. One. So in your syllabus, they have covered only one array list. Okay. So array list is a collection. Okay. Array list is a collection which provides the implementation of resizable array. Okay. So array list means it can able to grow dynamically, growable one. Okay. So array list which can be capable of dynamically growable one. Next. This is overall the hierarchical structure. Array list, from the last one, array list, which extends abstract list, which is the interface. Array list, which extends, which will be helpful for some MCQ path. Okay. Array list, which extends abstract list, which is the interface, which is the class. Abstract list, which implements list, which is the interface. List, which extends collection, so collection is the class. So overall, the head, iterable. Okay. So iterable, which is overall class, okay, the top level one. So this is the hierarchical structure. So the first point, the ArrayList class extends abstract list and implements the list interface. Okay. Second point, you have to import the package, utility package. If you want to use ArrayList in your programming, you should import the package java.utility. Okay. And the third point, important point, dynamic array. So if array list means the other name of the array list, which is the dynamic array. Okay. So array means which is static one. So array list support dynamic array that can grow as needed. And the next point, array list are created with an initial size. It is the optional one. Okay. And sometimes you can create an array list with empty, or sometimes you can create an array list with some initial size. Okay, so it is an optional one. It is based on your choice. You can create your array list with an, or you can create array list as empty, or you can create array list as some initial capacity. When the size is exceeded, if I'm initializing with the array list with the size 10 means, when the size is exceeded, the collection. Collection means what? Array list. Array list is one of the collection. The collection is automatically enlarged. It is automatically enlarged. Sometimes when objects are removed, the initial size is 10, but only the 5 objects. So here, why it is objects? So which means array list can able to handle only object, not primitive type. You're not int. Primitive type is what? Int, float. So these things are primitive data type. But in array list, important point, this is the point. The array list which will handle only the objects. So when objects, so the elements in array list is object only. What are all the elements in array list, which is typically object. Okay. So when objects are removed, the array may be shrunk. If the initial capacity is 10 names, only I have included 5 names, it is automatically shrunk. Okay. That is resizable one, dynamic array. Okay. So these are the important points. The Java utility package, dynamic array. You can create an array with initial size. Okay. So the elements in array list, which is typically object. Okay. Next. Some constructors. There are three constructors are used in array list, a predefined constructor. The first one, array list. The second one, array list collection extends. Okay. So because array list is one of the member of the collection. So array list, you can specify array list with initial capacity. Okay, this is the empty. Okay. This is initial capacity. The first one and three, which will be used at most time. Next, why not always use an array list instead of an array? Okay, so compare it to array means you can't resize the array, but array list you can able to resize the array, which is dynamic array, right? So array list, which is resizable one, it is compared with efficient based on the efficiency array, which is the best. An array list is less efficient than an array. So important point, the first one, a convenient square bracket notations are eligible in array, right? So arrays are represented using a convenient square bracket notation, but how to represent arrays is somewhat difficult. Okay, let us see in the next slide how to initialize an array list. But arrays, which is easiest one, a convenient square bracket notation. Okay, second important, the base type of an array list must be a class type. It cannot be a primitive type. Class type, which means what? Array list, which can able to hold objects. Okay. But array, it can be able to hold both object as well as primitive. Okay. Array can be able to handle both objects as well as primitive data types. But array list can able to only hold objects, not primitive data types. Okay, so that is why array is more efficient in some cases. It is based on the typical application. Okay, next, some important points on array list. The first point, the array list class can contain duplicate elements. So why the first point will come here means duplicate elements. It allows a duplicate element, which means if I am already added in a 5 into the array list. If I want to add one more 5 means, it is acceptable one in array list. Why means some other collection. Some other collections are there. Some example set. So array list, which is the member of list. One more collection family is there. That is set. So this collection family doesn't allow any duplicate elements. It is automatically eliminated. If you try to insert any duplicate element, means it is automatically negligible. Okay. Excluded from the set. So one more member is that set. That is why the first point will come here. A Java array list class can contain duplicate elements. It is capable have contain duplicate elements. Second, Java array list class maintains insertion order, which means the order which we have inserted, that order only it will be displayed. Okay, so it maintains insertion order. The third point which comes into the multi-threaded environment. While we know the topic threading or multi-threading in Java, you can familiar with the term synchronized. Okay, so as of now, we just know that Java array list class is non-synchronized. Okay, it doesn't support the multi-threaded environment. Okay, so synchronized, these terms are coming to the further chapters. Okay, in multi-threaded in Java. Okay, so as of now, just know about Java array list class is non-synchronized. Next, Java array list allows random access. Okay, yes, both same as array, which is also support random access. Okay, you can get the element from index first index. You can get the element from intermediate index. You can get the element from last index. Okay, so random access support random access because it is also based on index basis. Okay, next. This is a few points related to array list. Okay, this is see how to define an array. See how to define an array list. Starting with array list, this is the type. If you are going to perform any integer means, this is the type you have to explicitly mention integer. Okay, so this is the type of the array, and this is name of the array. A list. This is the name of the array. User choice. Next, equal to starting with the new array list. Okay, since array list you are since it is a class, so you are creating here memory the new array list. This is also the type. Okay, here empty array. So I'm just creating here empty array. If I'm including this is 5 means initial capacity. Okay, so this is optional one. So mostly I preferable to use empty. Next, this is the syntax of the array. Next, one of the example here, the type of the array list, the type of the array list which is string. Okay, so if you are mentioned this string here, string means your array list can only have capable of having string. Okay, if you are try to insert any other than type means, it will definitely throw an error. So since here your array list which is a typical string, here name of the array list which is list, so creating the memory new array list here initial capacity which is 20. Okay, so this is example. Next, some important methods in array list. Okay, the first, how to insert element in the array list, important question, right? How to insert an element into the array list using the add method. Okay, so this is the syntax of add method. So as this is our string, existing array list which is the type string. Okay, so for string I'm just adding the element in the double quotes. Okay, so starting with name of the array list, so here your name of the array list which is list, so list dot add of something, this is the element. Okay, since your existing array list which is a string, so double quotes something which is the element in the string array list. This same thing, add is overloaded means what? I can able, if I'm for different operations you can perform add, not only string, you can able to add integer for integer type of array list. Okay, float means float type of array list. Okay, that is why the point is added here, add is overloaded. Okay, next important one, size. Okay. Again post in the chat box in array, how to find the length of the array. I'm talking about array. How to find the length of the array? I'm asking you students to post in your chat box how to find the length of the array. So in the quiz part only you have already seen how to find the length of the array. I think it is audible to you. How to find the length of the array? In the quiz part only the for loop. I have already mentioned the for loop. Okay, no one. Actually, how to find the length of the array? Length. I'm talking about array length. Likewise, in array list. Okay, so likewise in array list. The method which is size. Okay, so array, how to find the length of the array which means length, how to find the length of the array list which is size method. Okay, this is the, maybe it is, maybe will be asking for your two mark. Okay, so the size method is used to find out how many indices or how many elements already in the array list. Okay, so this is the way of how to use your size which is retrieve an integer element. So I'm initializing here int how many equal to here your name of the array list dot size. Okay, so second method size, important method size, which is over. Next, some more methods, the two important methods, set and get method. Okay, the set method, what is the purpose of set method? It is these methods are already predefined. Okay, The set methods is used to replace any existing element. If you want to replace any existing element from the array list, means you can probably use set method. Get method is used to access the value of any existing element. Okay, if you want to access any particular element, means if you want to access any element, and particularly means you have to use get method. So this is the syntax. So in the set method, so index means in the index part, giving the index value. So for the particular index, that value is replaced by something else. This is set. Get method, which is used for retrieving the element from the particular index. So get us some index value means that value is particularly retrieved. Okay. So this is the set and get. Same thing. Constructors. Okay. Same constructors. Here. I have already seen in the previous slides. Actually, in the previous slides, we have seen about three types of constructor. But here, the two important ones. These two are important one. Okay, the constructors in array list. So this is the. These two are the just example. The first one, initializing array list with some initial capacity, which is 10. The second one, empty list. Okay, these two are possible. You can use either first one or either two second. Okay, I will go through program. The last one thing. Next, same thing repeated. Set and get. Okay, set method is used to replace any element from the array list. Get method is used to retrieve some element. Okay, based on the index. Next thing, add. There are two types of add here. Okay, so here. First add, already we have seen in the previous thing, that is the first add. Second add, which is used for add, insert the new element, okay, in the specified index. Okay, so actually the first one, which is the most important one, then in the second. Okay. Second thing, as add, you can have remove, which is based on the index. You can remove all else, you can remove on the particular index. So these are the important array list methods. So methods means add, set, get, and then size, remove. Okay, the various constructors, so important things we have seen. Okay, second, one example. See here, since this is the array list program, I just import the package, utility package. Okay, and just import the package, utility here. Next. Okay, this is the class test array list. Then within the main, I'm just initialize the array list. I'm using the list as string. Okay, so array list, the type, then name of the array list, array one. Okay, so this is how to create a array list with the initial capacity 10. Okay, so this is the syntax. Okay, this is the syntax for initializing array list, declaring array list. Next, adjust here, print the elements of array list. System dot out dot print ln of array one. Array one is the name of the array, but I'm not add any element in the array. So since I'm not add any element, the first printed, which is the empty here, the empty list. Okay, if I'm trying to print the elements in the array list in the form of system dot array out dot println of just array name, means the output in the format of list format. That's like in the Python, in list format. Okay, but here no more elements, it's already no more elements in the your given array, so this is empty list. Okay, second I'm just add string values, since your existing array, which is the type of string, name of the array, array one dot add of Agamar, array one dot add of, this is the next one, this is three values of I have added. Next, I just print the element, system dot out dot println of array one. Okay, system dot out dot println of array one. So what will happen here? Agamar insertion order. First I have added Agamar, then Khalid, then Ali. So it follows the insertion order in the output. Agamar, Khaled, and Ali. Next, and on the particular, I'm just using the set method. So name of the array, array list array 1 dot set of 0 means you are the index value. So 0 means here it points to the first element. The first element in the array list is replaced by Fahad. Okay, so system dot out dot println of array 1 means Fahad, Kalan, Ali. The argument is replaced by Fahad. Okay, so this is the way of how to use array list. Next, also some few methods. These methods are pertaining to your HackerRank problems. Okay, so while solving your HackerRank problems, this contains method is helpful for contains method, which is, see here, it returns true. It returns true if the calling array list contains target. Okay, just you have to check whether your array list has Agamath. Okay, so your target is Agamath. You are going to check whether this element is present or not. Okay, if present means true will be returned. If no, that element is existing means false will be returned. Okay, contains index of. Okay, so index of means return the index of the first element. Since my target is Agamath means, if two times Agamath is repeated means, because array list allows duplicate elements, right? Since array list allows duplicate elements, index of object target means the first element, which is the first index element, okay, which will be retrieved. Okay, now last index means, see if Agamath appeared in two times, for example, in a zero part, Agamath is there. Okay, so in the fifth index part, Agamath is there means the first index of means it returns the first one. Last index of means the target which returns the fifth one. Okay, so this is the, so these things are very helpful when we are solving the HackerRank solutions. Okay, that is why I covered here is empty. Just going to check where array list is empty or not. Okay, so this is empty. That is size of is empty means your size is zero. Next, same thing. Okay, some advanced some methods, same method size. Okay, ensure capacity. Okay, so ensure capacity, which is the least privilege I'm giving this ensure capacity. So this method actually takes the desired minimum capacity as a parameter. Okay, minimum capacity as a parameter, it is used to increase the capacity of already initialized arrays. If I already initialized array list 10 means, ensure capacity of 5 means after, then that array is just converted into initial capacity of 10 to 50. Okay, 10 plus 5, 50. So that is a very less part. So ensure capacity means it is used to increase the capacity of already initialized array list to a desired size. Okay, so 3 to size, which is the based on, these are some advanced methods. Okay, so dream to size, which is the storage purpose. Okay, then here one important thing based on the HackerRank solutions, how to convert array list into array. So actually there are two types in there, how to convert array list into array. Okay, so these actually these parts are very helpful while solving the HackerRank solutions. Okay, actually three type, you can use either object model, second model, you can use either this or that. Okay, so there are two types are there. Okay. Next thing, how to iterate the array. How to iterate the array using the first for each loop. The two methods are there. Second one is iterator. Okay, for each loop means enhanced for loop, which is we have already seen in the array concept. Okay, which was delivered by ma'am, Aarti ma'am. For each loop, advanced for loop. Example, this is the example. Okay, utility package, since you are using array list, so you should import the package utility. Then this is the name of the class within the main function. I'm just initializing the array. See here, one more doubt is raised here. It is starting with the list. Okay, it is also acceptable one because array list which is a member of the list. Okay, so it is starting with the list here. It is also acceptable one, but you can prefer to starting with array list. Okay. then here I'm just initializing the array here. Here I'm just initializing the array value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for each loop means here for each loop. So here I'm using integer, not int. Okay. Instead of int, I'm using integer here. So why I'm using integer here? Because the elements of the array list are object, not a primitive one. So in the iterative thing, I'm just starting with integer. Okay, integer I, which is the iterator. Then numbers, which is your given array list. System.out.println of I means the 1 by 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which will be displayed. Okay, this is the one of the method. The second method, iterator method. Iterator method means this. You are initializing just iterator. Okay, so iterator. Here iterator is there. So this is the object of the iterator, IT. So your type of the array list, numbers, numbers dot iterator. So this is the function. Okay, so two important methods are that used in array list, which is has next, which is used to helpful to find the next element. Okay, whether next element is possible or not. This is the actual structure of iterator. You should use while loop. So within the while loop, IT dot has next. Okay, if next element is possible, then system dot out dot printer of IT dot next. IT, which is the iterator, iterator dot next. The next element is printed 1 by 1. Okay, so this is the way how to use the how to iterate over an array list. Okay, now we move on to the sample program. Visible to you. So first, the simple program, ArrayList program. Since ArrayList, I just import Java dot stuff. Okay, this is the package I should import here. Next, one class demo. Array list, the name your choice. Okay. Class is there. Then just adding up. Function. Then starting with that yes. Then I'm just going to select the array. So array list. And the caps here, okay, array list, the type, here I'm using the type, integer, integer, so name of the array, I just am putting list, and new, array list, the type, which is integer, then I'm just initialized empty array, okay. Next, I'm going to add some elements. So list is the name of the array, list dot add of 1, the integer value is just 1, list dot add of 2, then list dot add of 3, so just 3 elements I have added here. Next, I just print the array using the list format, system dot out dot print the list. Okay. Just list the elements. Just list the elements in the list format. Next, using this for each loop, that is advanced for. Advanced for. This is the type of the array, which is integer. Integer. Okay. So integer. This is the iterator for integer. I. The name of the array list. Just system dot dot println of I, the iterator only. This is the one method. one minute, I just change the value. One close, two close. Work three. Java. My command prompt. Take time. Okay. Let's move on to my F colon. F colon. I put work 3 Java Suite dot Java. So I'm trying to compile the program. Demo on a list. Okay, no more error. Java demo on a list. See, this is the list format. First system dot out dot print list format. These two are using the for each loop. Okay. So one more iterator, which means iterator, right? So iterator, which means iterator. And just create the object for the iterator ID. So list dot iterator is a function. Iterator. And so in this a while loop. Sorry, while loop. And the while loop id dot has next. Which will return true or false. Just system dot out dot print of the print id dot next. Next. Almost over. Third way of iterating. Actually, this is the one method for each loop. This is the iterator. Okay. So here, this is the first just list system dot out dot println of list. Okay, displaying element in the list. So this is three is a for each loop. This is 1, 2, 3 using iterator. If I'm using here print ln means, so print ln means it will display as 1 by 1. So this is for first system dot out dot println. This is for each loop, and this is for iterator. Okay. Okay, students, thank you, students. Almost the time is over.